subscribe to my channel Your Tech Bro and hit the bell icon to get the instant notifications about the tech as soon as we upload. Hey, hi guys, this is Dhanashekaran back here, and in this video let's just unbox the Moto G5 S Plus, which is the combination of the Motorola and the Lenovo, which had hit the online markets few weeks earlier. So without further ado, let's unbox it. Well, this is the box itself, and over to the front you see the Moto and the Lenovo branding, and this is a special edition one brought from Amazon. Let's begin the unboxing, and let me just take the seal off. Okay. Opening the box, you get to see the device over the top itself. Let me just keep it aside. You get some paperwork like reading instructions and the warranty card along with the SAR value. A turbocharger from Motorola, which charges at 5 volts at 9 amps. A pair of standard and basic earphones, which is of a low quality, but okay for a budget oriented device. A charging cable, which is a micro USB one, but not a type C. Last but not the least, a SIM ejector tool. Keeping all this aside, let's move on to the device itself. Let's have a physical overview of the device. Over the front, you have an 8 megapixel front shooter and a front LED flash, a Moto branding below the earpiece, a 5.5 inch Full HD display. To the very bottom you get a fingerprint scanner, which is not a capacitive button. To the left you don't have anything except a SIM card tray, which is of a hybrid one. Over the right you have a power button, which is being present below the volume rockers. To the very bottom of the device, moving from right to left, you get a mono speaker and a charging space and a mic for the device. At the top, you will be having a 3.5 mm jack, and at the back, you will be having a dual camera setup, which is a 16 megapixel one, and a Motorola symbol, a flashlight and some branding at the bottom. Well, this is how the device looks like after completing all the initial setup, and the device is pretty prestigious to hold in hand thanks to the metallic finish mounting all over the surface of the device. Diving into the device, this device runs on the stock Android ROM. As this is a Motorola device, you get a stock Android OS. This device is very fluid in motion, as even though this is a mid-range device. Sadly, you don't get any physical back buttons over the device. You have to manage with the on-screen ones. Moving on to the settings and scrolling down to the about phone, we see the current Android version running on this device is Android 7.1.1, which is Android Nougat, and there is a sure update for Android Oreo. The latest security patches updated is June 1. Let's just go back to storage and see the storage of the device. And this device has a 64 gigabytes of internal storage. Out of 64, you get around 54 GB. So storage might not be a big issue on this device. Even though it's issue, you can just manage using your SD card, as this is hybrid SIM slot. and just go to the SIM cards. And this device is VoLTE enabled, so no issues, you can use your Geo SIM in this device. Let's just scroll down and just go to the tap and pay option. You can just pay whenever and wherever you want using the Android Pay, as this device is NFC supported. Just get back now and we'll be just moving back. Let me just go for the Moto features and gestures and shaking it twice you can just enable the flashlight and disable it too. Let's just go for the fingerprint sensor. The fingerprint is much accurate than the G5 Plus and just recognize on the go. It is fast and accurate also, as you can see. Let's move on to the camera, as this device has a dual camera setup rather than the single in the Moto G5 Plus. One is the normal shooter and the next is a depth enabled one. Both have a just 13 megapixel shooting capacity. Let's just take a sample and just view it. The camera samples in the indoor lighting just came out good, not too bad, and it's just of a sort of average one, which is good for a mid-range device. And let's just shoot a depth enabled picture. The shutter speed is average, but it's a bit faster when compared to the previous G5 Plus shutter speed. This is a sample picture of a depth enabled one, where keeping on all the places being blur except the point of focus. And you can also edit using your depth editor. You can just select a layer over to it, or just select a point and the background can be a black and white one. Anything you can make it in it, as you guys can see now. Let me just discard it and just move back and show you to the next editing option. And this is a selective focus, where you can adjust the blurriness at the back or just make it low or make it high. Let me just discard it and just go to the next option, replace the background, where you can replace this image as a foreground for any other images, as you guys are seeing right now. Let me just make it small. Here it is. This image will be a foreground of the previously taken image. Let me just discard everything and just leave back and show you the sample images took using this phone around my office. This is the video quality of the Moto G5S Plus, and this is in 4K video recording at 30 frames per second. I was just walking right now so that you guys can see the stabilization of the video. So this is the maximum resolution being set in, that is 4K at 30 frames per second.
So the audio is via the input mic of the G5S Plus.
I'm just ending the video at this point and hope you guys enjoy this unboxing. So let me just use this device for a couple of days and just come back with an in-depth review of this device. If you like this video, please don't hesitate to hit the like button, and if you have not subscribed to our channel yet, make sure you have subscribed to our channel and hit the bell icon.